Dear students, now we are going to see about sewer system. What is sewer system? The part of the plant which are present above the soil in aerial are called as sewer system. The part of the plant which is formed from plumule, which is called as sewer system. The plumule of the embryo of a germinating seed grows into stem. The epicotyl, epicotyl means, if a seed, if you germinate a seed, first they can produce radical, then shoot system, this side and that side, cotyledon will be there. From the cotyledon, above the tip will be called as epicotyl. From the cotyledon, at the lower tip of the root is called as hypocotyl. So, the epicotyl or shoot system, hypocotyl or root system. So the plumule or the epicotyl elongates after embryo grows into the axis of the stem that bears leaves from its tips, which contain the actually dividing cells of the shoot called apical meristem. So due to apical meristem, they can produce shoot system. For the cell divisions and growth result in the formation of mass of tissues called a leaf primordium. The point from which the leaf arises are called as nodes. So wherever the leaves are arises, that part is called node. The region between two adjacent nodes are called as internode. So students, very important, what is node, what is internode? The node is nothing but where the leaf is arises, the place in which the leaf is arises, the point from which the leaf is arises is called as node. In between two nodes are called as, the space in between two nodes are called as, or the region in between two adjacent nodes are called as internodes. Now we are going to see about characteristic features of stem. What are the characteristic features of stem? Stem is aerial, green, photosynthetic, and has nodes and internodes. But in root system, there is no nodes and internodes. It is positively phototrophic and negatively geotrophic. It is being against, it grow against root. It has nodes and internodes, very important. Nodes and internodes are absent in root system. Stem bears vegetative buds for vegetative growth of plants and floral buds also. The floral buds can able to produce flower, fruits, seeds and so on for reproduction. And ends in terminal buds. The young stem is green and thus carries out photosynthesis. During reproductive growth, the stem bears flowers and fruits. Branches arises exogenously. Some stems bear multicellular hairs of different kinds. Then, what are the functions of stem? Once again, how we have seen about the functions of root having two different functions, like primary function as well as secondary function. Stem is also possess the same kinds of primary function and secondary function. What is primary function? What is its original function of stem? Stem provides support and bears leaves, flowers and fruits. Stem transports water and minerals, mineral nutrients to the other part from the root. It transports food prepared by leaves to the other parts of the plant body. Then, what are the secondary function? Apart from these functions, the plant are doing this, the stems are doing some other function as well. These functions are not regular for every plant. These are not regular functions for each and every stem of the plant. Such a type of functions will be called a secondary function. In order to do the secondary function, they can modify. What are the different types of secondary function? Food storage, pollination, water storage, buoyancy, photosynthesis, protection and support. So these are all some important secondary function. So some of the stem can able to store the food material. For example, solanum tuberosum, potato, colocasia, ginger officinalis, inji. They are all which are storing the food material. So they are doing storage and function. Pernation and reproduction. What do you mean by pernation? Pernation means once again, year after year, they can able to form. It's a called as pernation. For example, ginger officinalis, inji, curcuma longa, manjal. These are all able to store the food material. As well as they can pernate. Season after season, they can able to produce new plant from the underground rhizome. Water storage. Some of the plant like opuntia which can able to store water in stem. These are called as water storage. Buoyancy. Buoyancy means they can able to float on the surface of water with the help of a specialized stem. Neptunia is a very good example. Photosynthesis and function. Opuntia, Ruscus, Euphorbia. All the leaves are modified to spines, are completely reduced or even absent. So in the place of leaves, the stem is doing in function. So this is called the stem is doing photosynthetic in function. Opuntia is a very good example. Chapati kani. Then protection. Some of the stems are protecting the plant with the help of spines, thorn, or specialized chemical can be able to secrete. For example, citrus. Citrus means elamichai, naartha, orange. These are all comes under citrus. Bougainvillea. Bougainvillea means kagidapu. Acacia. Acacia means bubble plant. So these are having thorns, spines, which can be able to protect by themselves. So the stem is modified to protect with the help of this support. And supporting function, Passiflora, Vitis, Cissus, Goldranularis, these are supporting. Supporting means they are climbing on some other plant, giving support. So that's all about modification of stem. Now we are going to see about buds. What is buds? Buds are the growing points surrounded by protective scale leaves. The buds primordium mature into bud. They have compressed axis in which the internodes are not elongated and the young leaves are closed and crowded. So buds are nothing but they have compressed axis in which the internodes are not elongated and the young leaves are closed and crowded. They are called as buds. When these buds develop, the internodes elongates and the leaves are spread out. Buds have architecture identical to the original shoot and develop into lateral branches or may terminate by developing into a flower or inflorescence. Based on origin, buds are classified into terminal buds or apical buds, lateral buds or axillary buds. In such a way, buds are divided. Here the buds are present at the tip of the plant or tip of the branches, which will be called as terminal buds or apical buds. Here the buds are present on the axis of leaf, which are called as lateral or axillary buds. Even they may call axil buds. Based on the function, buds are classified into two major types of buds, namely vegetative buds, second one is floral or reproductive buds. What is the difference between vegetative buds and floral buds? Vegetative buds which can be able to produce stem, leaves, branches and so on. Floral buds can able to produce flowers and inflorescences. So these are the main thing about these two buds of vegetative and floral buds. As I said just now, if the buds are present at the apex of the main stem and the tip of the branches are called as terminal buds or apical buds. On the other hand, the buds occurs in the axil of leaves and develop into branches of flowers or branches will be called as lateral buds or axillary buds. Sometimes the buds are formed at node but outside the axil of leaf. Usually the branch is formed if it is produced on the axil of leaf, means that is lateral buds or axillary buds. Some of the buds are formed at the node of the axil of the leaf. These are called as extra axillary buds. Example, Solanum americanum. And extra buds are either side, both side, collateral bud, or above, superposed bud, or serial bud, or axillary bud, will be comes under accessory buds. Example, Citrus durata. Now we are going to see about adventitious buds. Buds arises at any part other than the stem are known as adventitious buds. Radical buds are those that arises from the lateral roots which grow into plantlets, which are called as. Dear students, now we are going to see about corymb buds. Corymb buds arises directly from the stem, either from cut, pruned end or from branches. Adventitious buds function as probables which are produced on the stem as a tuberous structure. So Diascoria agave is a very good example for corymb buds. Next one is bulbils, a specialized buds. Bulbils are modified and enlarged buds, mean for propagation. When bulbils detach from the parent plant and fall on the ground, they may germinate into new plant and serve as a mean of vegetative propagation. Example, agave and Allium proliferum. Now we are going to see about types of stem. Majority of the angiosperm possess upright vertical growing erect stem. There may be many types, namely excurrent, decurrent, caudex and culm. What is excurrent? The main axis show continuous growth and the lateral branches grow gradually becoming shortened towards the apex, which gives a conical appearance to the trees. For example, Casuarina, Polyarthia longifolia, Manon longifolium, these are all very good examples. That means they used to grow only tip, there is no lateral branches will be developed. It is forming like a highest plant. You might also hear about Asoka tree, it's a very good example. Sauk is another example for exudate. Next, decurrent. What is decurrent? Have you seen mango plant? The growth of lateral branches is more vigorous than main axis, just opposite to exudate. So the lateral branches maybe grow very vigorously, very most speed than the main axis. The tree has rounded or spreading appearances. Example, Mangifera indica. Next one is caudex. Caudex means there is no branches. It is unbranched stout cylindrical stem marked with scar of falling leaves. Coccus nucifera, coconut, palm, tennamaram, panamaram, these are all comes under example Codex. Next, Kalm. Kalm means bamboo like plant. Erect stems with distinct nodes and usually hollow internodes, clasped by leaf sheath. Have you seen Moongil bamboo plant? So these are having erect distinct node. Number of nodes may be there. Each and every node possesses plenty of leaves. Usually in the internodal region and inside the internodal region, they may be hollow, empty space, hollow internodes. It is surrounded by plenty of leaf sheaths. Majority of the grasses, including bamboo, will be comes under Kalm. Now, what are the modifications which will be takes place instead? So, due to the secondary function, stems are modified in some form. Aerial modification of stem first. Generally, stem modification is broadly divided into three type, namely aerial modification, sub-aerial modification, underground modification. These aerial modifications which are takes place above the ground level, underground modification which is takes place below the ground level, sub-aerial modification is takes place on the ground. So on the base surface, the stem modification is divided into three types. Aerial modification. Creepers. Creeper means creeping on the surface. Then trailers. Percument, decumment, diffuse. Trailer means which can able to grow on the ground, just raise the level. Raise the tip of the level. Then climber. Climber will be getting support from another plant or another wall or even any support. Will be called as climbers. These are having root climber, stem climber, tendril climber, hook climber, lioness, thorn climber, and so on. Then phylloclad. Stem is modified as a leaf. Cladon. The branch, one or two branches may be function as leaf. Thorn. Certain thorn leaves are modified into thorns. So these are aerial modification. Then underground modification, which takes place at the base underground. Example, bulbs, onion, corm, colocasia, rhizome, ginger, turmeric-like plant, tuber, potato. Sub-aerial modification on the surface of soil, runner, grass, stolon, pistia, succus, chrysanthemum, opsep, pistia, in such a type of various kinds of stem modifications occur. Among them, aerial modification, we shall see first. So modification takes place on the air or above the ground level will be considered as aerial modification. Among them, first one is creepers. These are the plants growing closer to the ground on horizontal surface, not vertically, horizontally to the ground, and produce roots of each and every nodes. Example, cyanodonta, dactyla, centella are very good example. Next one is trailer. Trailer are nothing but these are also growing along the ground horizontally, but at the tip will be raised above, will be comes under climb, trailer. That we can see one by one. It is weak stem that spread over the surface of ground without rooting. The previous one is on the surface with roots at every nodes. But here, there is no roots at all. But it is having a branches for a long node without rooting at nodes. They are divided into two types, namely prostrate or procumbent, decumbent and diffuse. First of all, prostrate, the stem that grows flat on the ground, Indigophora prostrata. Decumbent, the stem that grow flat but becomes erect during reproductive stage. Pridax. Axil is diffuse. The trailing stem with spreading branches, various branches, may be arises. Boyer area diffuse one. Next category is climbers. Climbers means they can climb over the support. These plants have long beak stem and produce special organs for attachment for climbing over a support. Climbing helps to display the leaves towards sunlight and to position the flower of effective pollination. Then root climbers. The climbers are further divided into root climbers, stem climbers and so on. Root climbing with the help of adventitious roots are called as root climbers. As it is present in Piper petal, Piper nigrum, pothos, these are all examples. வெத்தலை மிளகு இதெல்லாம் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா விச் இஸ் ஹேவிங் அ பிரான்சஸ் விச் இஸ் ஹேவிங் ரூட்ஸ் தி வித் த ஹெல்ப் ஆஃப் ரூட்ஸ் தே கேன் சப்போர்ட் தீஸ் ஆர் கால்ட் அஸ் ரூட் கிளைம்பர்ஸ் ஸ்டெம் கிளைம்பர்ஸ் வித் த ஹெல்ப் ஆஃப் ஸ்டெம் தே கேன் ஓவர் கிளைம்பிங் கஸ்கூட்டா கிளிட்டோரியா குவிஸ்காலிஸ் டயஸ்கோரியா தீஸ் ஆர் ஆல் வெரி குட் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஃபார் ஸ்டெம் கிளைம்பர்ஸ். These climbers lack specialized structure for climbing. They do not have any specialized organ for folding or handling the support. And the stem itself, they can coil around the support. Hypomia. Hypomia means, sacramentigallium, sweet potato, clitoria, quiscalis. These are very good examples. Stem climbers may be coiled around the support either clockwise or anti-clockwise. If it is clockwise, so clockwise coiling of climbers are called as dectrose, Dioscorea alata. If it is anti-clockwise coiling, climbers are called as silistrose, Dioscorea bulbifera. So next one is hook climbers. These plants produce a specialized hook-like structure, which are the modification of various organs of plants. In Arthrobotrys, inflorescence axis is modified into hook. In Calamus, curved hook. Leaf tip is modified into hook. In Bignonia, Vingiscatis, the leaflets are modified into curved hook. In Hugonia, the axillary buds modified into hook. The thorn climbers, certain plants are having thorn-like structure which will be acting to climb. Climbing or reclining on the support with the help of thorn as in bougainvillea and grissa. Next, lianas. In woody stump climbers, in tropical rainforest, these are the plants which are climbing on main tree subtrunks. Woody perennial climbers found in tropical forest or lianas. They twine themselves around the tall trees to get light. Example, Hepatage bengalensis, Bohemia bihali are very good example. Then tendril climbers. Tendrils are thread-like coiling structure which help the plant in climbing. In snake gourd, Podalangai, these are having a coil-like structure which is climbing on the support with the help of thread-like coil. Tendrils may be modification of stem, as in Vitis and Cissus gourdalis. The inflorescence axis also can be modified into climbers in Antigona. In certain plant like Lateris odoratus, leaf is modified to form tendrils. Certain plant like Pisum sativum, leaflets are modified into tendrils. Certain plants like Clematis, the petiole will be modified into tendrils. Some other plants like glorious or superba, the leaf tip is modified as tendril. In smilax, stipules are modified into tendrils. In Nepenthes, a pitcher plant, the midriff of the leaf often coils around a support like a tendril and hold the pitcher in a vertical position. So next one is pillar. Pillar is nothing but the stem is doing the function of leaf. Here leaf is completely modified or reduced or even absent. So in such a case, in the absence of leaf, stem is functioning like a leaf. What is the function of leaf? Photosynthesis. So usually photosynthesis is done by leaf, but here stem is doing the photosynthesis process. This is called as filler plant. In plant like opuntia and asparagus, this is green, flattened, cylindrical or angled stem or branch of unlimited growth consisting of a series of nodes and internodes at long or short intervals. Phylloclea is a characteristic adaptation of xerophytic, where the leaves often fall off early and modified into spines or even scales or to reduce to transpiration, because they are being in desert area or xerophytic condition in order to reduce water content, they used to be modified. The phylloclea takes over all the functions of leaves, particularly photosynthesis. The phylloclea is also called cladophyll. Opuntia, sapaticali, is a very good example. Phyllocactus, melanbeckia, flattened phylloclea, Casuarina, Sauku, Euphorbia thricoli, Euphorbia antiquara. So these are all some very good example for phylloclea. So next one is cladode. Cladode is a flattened or cylindrical stem similar to phylloclea, but one or two internodes only. In phylloclea, the entire plant stems are modified to form like a leaf, but here one or two internodal regions only will be flattened and become like a leaf. Their stem nature is evident by the fact that they bear buds, scales and flowers. Asparagus is a very good example. Even ruscus also can be considered. Next one is thorns. Thorn is a woody and sharp pointed modified stem. Either axillary buds or terminal buds gets modified into thorns. In citrus, elumichai and atlantia, axillary buds is modified into thorns. Next we are going to see about subaerial stem modification. Subaerial stem found in plants with weak stem, in which the branches lie horizontally on the ground. These are mean for vegetative propagation. They may be subaerial or partially subterranean. So these are very good example for subaerial modification. Runner. So this is an example for runner. This is oxalis plant. So the branches are running over the ground. Each and every node bears some roots. These are called as runners. So this is a slender prostrate branching, branch gripping on the ground and rooting at the nodes. Each and every node can able to produce roots. Oxalis, wood sorrel, long grass, cynodendron, nectarine. Then we are going to see about stolon, Fragaria. So little bit difference is there between this runner and the stolon. stolen. This is also a slender lateral branches originating from the base of the stem. The small buds and lateral roots, adventitious roots may be formed. Here internodal regions are moving away from the ground, but these are contacting to the ground. So this is also a slender lateral branches originating from the base of the stem, but it is grows obliquely above the ground. So these are flat on the ground, but this is obliquely above the ground. Produces a loop like structure, producing a loop like structure and bent out towards the ground. When touches the ground, it produces roots and becomes into independent plantlet. Mentha piperita, fragaria, these are example for stone. Next one is succus. In chrysanthemum plant, samandi, you might have seen. So this is a main plant. Certain branches of stem will be arises underground, air inclination, and the tip is airy. The succus develops from underground stem and grows obliquely towards and give rise to separate plantlet, this type of plantlet, and new plant. So chrysanthemum, bambusa are a very good example. Next, opposite, Heiconia, Ahaya Tamari. So these are very good example for opposite. Opposite is similar to runner but found in aquatic plants, especially in rosette leaved forms. A short thick lateral branches arises from the lower axil and grow horizontally leaflets. For a shorter distance, it produces bunch of rosette and leaves and at nodes. Iconia, water hyacinth, pistia are very good example. So that's all about subaerial modification. Now underground stem modification. Perennial and some biennial herbs have underground stems, which are generally known as rootstocks. Rootstocks function as storage and protective organ. It remains alive below the ground during unfavorable condition and resumes growth during the favorable conditions. Underground stems are not roots because they possess nodes, internodes, scale leaves and buds. So that is why they will not be called as roots. They are underground stem. Rootstock also root cap and whole root hairs as well. But they possess terminal buds, which is a characteristic of the stem. So they will not be considered as root. Lot of example. Bulbs, onion, allium sepal. These are example for bulbs. If you see bulbs, it is condensed conical or convex stem surrounded by a fleshy scaly leaves. There are two types. Tunicated bulb, coated like onion, in which stem is much condensed and surrounded by scale concentric layer of scale leaves. The inner scale commonly fleshy, the outer one is dry. They can be classified into two types, namely simple tunicated bulb, example Allium sepal, onion. Compound tunicated bulb, Allium sativa, vellifolium. So this is very good example for bulb. Comb, chana kalangu, chepangalangu, these are all comes under comb. So this is succulent. Succulent underground stem with erect growing tip. The comb is surrounded by leaves and root at nodes. So Iconia scale leaves are very good example. and exhibits nodes and internodes. Example, Amorphophallus, Colocasia, Colchicum. Next one is rhizome. Ginger, turmeric, manjal, inji. These are all comes under rhizome. So look at the picture. This is ginger, inji. This is an underground stem growing horizontally with several lateral growing tips. Rhizome possesses conspicuous nodes and internodes covered by scale leaves. Example, ginger officinalis, canna, curcuma longa, musa. These are all, musa means banana. These are all examples for rhizome. Next, tuber, potato. It's a branch of stem which is being undergrown to store food material. These are tuber. So this is a succulent, underground, spherical or globose stem with many embedded axillary buds called eyes. Solanum tuberosum, Helianthus tuberosus are very good example for this tuber.